real hard. But if you flank correctly and properly and explosively, you do not see the shot coming. Because positional dysphasia, or tunnel vision, is present in both parties. If these two are predatory, then their preparation to assault and fight must accompany the presence of adrenaline. The presence of adrenaline always accompanies the presence of tunnel vision. Which means if he's aggressive and angry with me here, yeah, and I suddenly move here, he's like, oh, shit, is he? Before he can possibly reorientate or get a grasp mentally on what's going on, you've already hit him. That's how flanking should be used, do you understand? If you take a motherfucking service to get there, then he will reorientate. So if this is your idea of flanking, just reorientate wherever I am, I do that, he just does that. What am I achieving? So it has to be quick. It's also useful if you do it, you know, with something that will take his attention. So this is distracting, isn't it? Acoustically it's distracting, and tactilely it's distracting. That's a good one. What's also you can do is rather than just flank this way, you put a little shot in the groin as you flank. So here, that's a flank. Now I'm already on the way to winning. Do you understand? Look at the tactical advantage I have here. If when I flank, I do that. Watch this. To lay the barrier. Flanking is a sound tactic to deploy when you're dealing with more than one subject. Another way in which you can employ this strategy to get this stacking thing is by shielding. So, if I was in a confined environment, so let's say I was in an alley, it's not possible to flank here. I have to do this. It's not. In this such place, you want to use shielding. I want to just hit, protect myself. So how I do that? So I'm clinching and then turn. There's a little quarter turn, that's what I mean. Now it's a shield. Before he can immediately get to me, he has to move to the outside. So here, look, he's got one thing to do to hit me. Bang. Here, he's got two things to do to hit me. One, then two. So I'm borrowing that moment. So I need to use that moment. If I just loosely grab him, like I want to take him home with me, and then turn him, I think he's going to be physically active. Of course he is, it's going to be happening. So when I grab him, I have to grab him ballistically. So one of the tools we employ secondarily is ballistic manipulation. You know it. Ballistic manipulation. So this would be a tight clinch. Just hold it. I want to ballistically clinch him so that his skull casing goes, oh, what does happen? This is a pattern interrupt. So I don't want you to do that to each other because it fucking sucks. But I'm going to ballistically clinch him so his attention is taken up. And then I'm going to turn. So it's clinch, relocate position. Then I'm going to. You understand? What I wouldn't do is clinch and nick. Because he'll hit me. Remember, I fought 1 second. Yes? Here he's got one thing to do to hit me. Bang. Here he's got two things to do to hit me. Which buys me the opportunity to take him, cover, bang, then deal with him, and now deal with him. So, first we're going to hit the position. This is called shielding. You're going to clinch, you're going to start like this, you're going to clinch, and turn. For the purpose of the drill, I want you to get used to shielding. So no assault yet. He's going to move here, you're going to turn. He's going to crack, you're going to turn. Then you're going to let him get close, here, and take him, and turn from him. See the deal? Then turn from here, 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 take him. And so on. So I want you to take one move. He'll move, you move. He'll move, take him, turn. Do not turn your back on anyone at any point. Make sense? Yeah. Right, so let this is you do it with you with one. So you're going to take him, move. He's around. And then you close back to the turn. very much, I'll get it. Yes. Right? What you would be doing inside of this dynamic is you'd be out here. You'd be taking him here, down by my elbow and stretching him to the floor. I'd be fucking him up. But before you fuck him up, you need to learn about where to move. Do you understand? So let's get this position and drill going. Understand the advantage that this gives you. What's your primary sense? Sight. Vision. We rely on what we see. Yes? But extremely close proximity, particularly when your vision is tunneled, your vision is impaired. Particularly when it's manic and it's moving. You know? Fight by its very nature is dynamic. It's moving. It's a struggle. It's a dynamic moving struggle. It's like being a biscuit in a biscuit tin, it looks like the biscuits get chewed up, isn't it? There's not a lot of visual intel. Hence the reason that if you can learn to be tactile and rely on touch, which is a secondary sense naturally. So if you get up in the middle of the night to go to the loo and it's pitch black, you default to vision until you find the light switch. Yes or no? So if you were visually working your way through something and then the power went out, you don't automatically do that. You go tactile. Because tactile sense of touch gives you an orientation. If I have the orientation of this head close to my body, do I need to look for where the point is, or can I about gather where it is? If I keep maintain a grip and release with one hand, still holding the head with the other hand, do I need to look at my target to hit it, or do you think I could probably work it out? Or should I fucking work it out? It's tactile. So what that means is, if there's two people, and I'm in this situation where I'm doing this, I ain't looking at him. I'm feeling him and dealing with him all the time whilst looking for him. Because I'm tactile. Do you understand the advantage? Right. So let's put that into play. You're going to grab a pad, and you're going to grab a pad. The best way to train this kind of thing is with body armor. So I put body armor on him, or just a groin guard and a hip guard. Now as I'm moving him around, I can basically hit the hip, and I can hit the groin. Yes? But for now, all you're going to do is attack the low one. I am, in effect, attacking high and low. Because the second I ballistically clinch you here, I'm hurting him. So I'm hurting him, turning, putting a shot in, boom, here, and I'm dragging him, and then him down, and so on. Do you understand? Sorry. So, here's what I want you to do. I want you to attach, turn. While he's trying to come to you, I want you to stay visual on him, attack along here. The whole time, pass in, pass the kick it, here, pass in, until you put him on the wall. And when he comes to each turn, he's a push with me, push with me, move you down, take you to me. Do you understand the drill? Now every single time, put the man down. The reality is, you clinch, knee, put him down, he's done. Then blitz him. And when you keep it going, so that you learn the principle. Make sense?
Yes.
Manage. You'll have a break.